teman-teman, kawan-kawan, tuan-tuan, puan-puan yang sudi datang, sudi memberi, para dermawan sudi membantu kami meneruskan perjuangan ini. Assalamualaikum, selamat malam, Ta Jia Hao. Dan juga Banakan. Saya sebenarnya bila bercakap pada malam ini, you know, it is a very heartfelt and meaningful night for me. Because throughout these years, when I first entered active politics with my 4-month-old baby, you know, and of course I was holding her, and then I made the decision, of course, to assist the party to promote a more multiracial future, multiracial politics for Malaysia. And to see all of you here with me, supporting me in this journey, you know, it is more important than just winning a seat, than just winning a government. Sometimes I wonder, how does it feel having a program and knowing that people who attend your program are there for the food or for the money? No, seriously. You see, what governs your decision as a leader? And I mentioned this for teachers, bankers, lawyers, politicians. We are leaders. What must guide us is the sense of moral courage, moral compass. You do things because it is right. And not because it is rewarding financially. So, yes, it's true. So tonight, I would really like you to know how I value the support. I value this entire journey, having gone through the difficulty, the trials, tribulations, to the point, mind you, saya sebut dalam sejarah saya berjuang ni lah dalam politik. I've never been so close to a muka penumbuk. And I remember when I was in Felda Lempar Hilir Satu, an area in Pahang that we've managed to make inroads in. You know, it's very difficult to actually gain support from the rural heartland. But because of the many policy mistakes committed by our confused, rather conniving Prime Minister, it has helped us to garner support from the civil servants, from even rural Felda settlers. And this is an important mark. And I remember I went there, about 100 strong crowd waiting to hear me speak, to hear YB Nazmi from Selangor speak. And this about 50 to 80 group of unruly UMNO supporters and members shouting non-stop. And then I realized they represent those who are fearful of losing power. And I'm telling you, you as a leader can never be fearful. You do your best. You inform the rakyat of the truth. You are merely the voice of the conscience of the rakyat. But you cannot. But you must never manipulate, abuse people, abuse institutions, just to maintain power. When I saw them shouting, I knew we have won. They are so fearful, despite the control on the media, despite the control on the papers. Tell me, any 1 minute, 2 minute footage given to the opposition on TV3? Never. Virtually all television stations, terrestrial stations, are controlled by the ruling coalition. they would have nothing to do with it. They would not allow me. And one man stormed towards me, trying to hit me. And, you know, I'm not a very confrontational person. My husband knows this. And so I think one of the reasons he's thankful he married me. Maybe he's rethinking the decision, I'm not sure. No, la, joking only, relax. But I think at that moment, you know, he was with me. You know, you just feel when you are in the right, God will assist you. And when I see such fear, it gives me greater sense, greater strength to continue, thank the local organizers, because they are the ones who have bravely faced such challenges and such fear tactics and such terrible, devilish use of racial politics. So because of this, I would like to reiterate to you, don't just feel that it's only amongst us, those in the urban heartland, as you might call it, they are embracing change. No, there's many others out there who feel similar, who want to see a future for Malaysia where politics shouldn't interfere in our daily lives, where everyone is accorded an equal opportunity, a piece of the economic cake, economic pie. Opportunity in our education system based on meritocracy. And the fact that when you are a Malaysian, it should not matter whether you are a Bumi Putra or not. Yeah. And that's why I would like to remind ourselves, despite the use of violence, hatred, anger, lies, malicious allegations, we must be clear-headed in our conviction, in our resolve to once and for all keep these political parasites from our country. Get down to the business of salvaging what is most crucial and valuable to all of us. Ravi Kitsiang is here, please. The moment of power, round of applause. Illustrious leader of the Commission of Humankind, Member of Parliament for Ipoh Barat. I'd like to know, not easy to get Kitsiang here, so please, people. Thank you very much, Ravi. Oh yeah, my father-in-law also in a cap. Thank you, Abah, for coming, see? Now, before I am forced to end my speech because all of you are excited with Kitsiang's entry, you see, a politician also must have their pulse right on the ground. You cannot be deluded in a sense of grandeur. You think that everyone loves me. That table told me I am a very pretty MP. Cannot. You cannot fall into the trap. You must encircle yourself with those who are idealistic, honest, pragmatic, and sincere to the cause. Anna knows this because, you know, like Anna, in my cabang, she was the one who asked me to sell my favorite guitar. She said, YB, for the cause, you must give up something you love so that we can ensure people can judge your actions more openly. So there goes my guitar and more funds for the party, hopefully. Now, back to the issue at hand. We know that things are not going to change under this Prime Minister. He is going to make an important announcement tonight in Johor. Whatever it may be, I am telling you, we are facing not only a moral deficit in terms of leadership, but a possibility of bankruptcy if we allow this current government to continue with its misdeeds. I was really shocked because of the many NFC exposés, and there's many. For those of you who have not been following up with the news, NFC stands for National Peacock Corporation. It's a project, of course, by my predecessor in Lembah Pantai. And I have with me people who are living in Abdullah Hukum, who are formerly from Kampung Haji Abdullah Hukum. They've been evicted. Okay, one of the ladies, Puan Gayatri, she came to my office today. She was there when the emergency rule was in effect. They came part of the Tun Razak's Peneroka Bandar scheme, and they were based there. And her children were denied housing when they were evicted, asked to be removed because of the development in what is now known as KL Eco City. But before you know it, you find that Dato' Sri Shariza's husband has obtained 6 units in the proposed development. And the UMNO youth outfit, Yayasan Gerak Bakti Kebangsaan, supposedly to uphold Bumi Putra rights, etc., got the land and a handsome profit of 75 million ringgit after selling it off to SP Setia. So I asked in Parliament last session, what is this model of successful windfall profit? Because it's basically akin to untung atas angin, and you take away the rights of the downtrodden, and we're not asking for much. We're asking for us to be fair, for the government to be fair. And in any development, you should only allow those who are capable, who can develop certain plots. Anyhow, so it's quite clear-cut what are the problems facing our nation economically, politically, socially, and I do not see an end in sight with Perkasa's dominance. Especially, we're not talking about the existence of certain right extremist groups, but this is with the tacit support of the government of the day, and that is unacceptable. So for me, in Pakatan Rakyat, you have a few of the leaflets that we've handed out, because some of you came back to me and asked, why don't you promote more on what are your plans for Malaysia? And I'm telling you, all the 3 parties in the opposition have reaffirmed our policies in a common policy framework. Vis-a-vis the future of subsidies, for example, in the Alternative Budget 2012, which I will invite you to read for Pakatan Rakyat, the move is to shift phasing out subsidies so that we make a more efficient use of those subsidies, identifying those from the poorer segment. Right now, I know for a fact one of the reasons why an MCA Datuk was given BRIM 500 ringgit handout is because of the weaknesses in the system. So these are part of the policy pronouncements to ensure whatever happens, the government of the day must not encroach or crowd out private investments. With regards to even making sure we bring Malaysians back into Malaysia, okay? Overseas who have worked there, and I detest many people trying to singularly find out whether they're Malays, Chinese or Indians. For me, one Malaysian, regardless of race, who has left the country, we must understand it is a loss to us because they rightly should be here together being celebrated for working to improve the economy. So this is the tactic, the position that we have to take. I don't care whether Chinese or Indian, the point is they are Malaysians. So this is the crux of the position that we are proposing. Now, for the next parliamentary session, the Prime Minister will table a host of reforms, but I am telling you, only piecemeal, and is going to bring us backwards, similar to the Peaceful Assembly Bill of last year. So in this session, As promised in Pakatan Rakyat Buku Jingle, I'm going to table three crucial bills as a private member of parliament. The first is to amend Article 1211 to its original position so that our courts, our judiciary will be accorded its judicial powers. It will check the excesses of the executive, the prime minister, the ministers, etc. So whatever the judges have said, whatever Mahathir has done in strangulating our judiciary will be undone when we return Article 121 to its original position. Please support me in this. Number two, Petronas has been completely used. Almost 500 billion ringgit of Petronas money has been used since its inception. You cannot see in terms of our human capital development, you can't see in terms of the state of our education, being used for what? Just to fulfill the desires of the prime ministers in Malaysia. Putrajaya, whatnot, whatever. So I'm tabling another bill to amend the Petroleum Development Act so that we make sure the Prime Minister can never abuse our coffers again. And number three, okay, not cheap, these amendments, thank God the Bar Council, someone have helped, but sometimes not very easy for us to draw. And number three is to abolish the Printing Practices and Publications Act. So our mainstream media can kindly do some investigative journalism so we don't have to count cows any longer. Seriously, it's very tiring. Member of Parliament must table legislation, Member of Parliament must do many, many things, so we would like to allow for a more conducive, open environment for the media to really live up to its potential in terms of ethical journalism. So this is the three plans, and I will end there. I will just ask you to continue to support, and thank you for giving me the feedback, giving me the response, giving me the encouragement I need to continue fighting, even in the hinterland of Belgrade. Whatever happens, and when we make it, we have a plan in action. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good night to everyone, and of course, look forward to our speakers. Good night. The food is supposed to be from Kelana Seafood Centre, so if it's not nice, you can blame them.